Hi, I'm Matthew Coast, head dating coach and founder at commitmentconnection.com. In today's video, we're going to talk about how to get him to commit in the age of the hookup culture. So as you probably know by now, the hookup culture has really kind of spread like wildfire through Western society. Everybody's just trying to hook up with each other, and it's just, yeah, Tinder, everybody's, let's just hook up. It's just a big hookup thing going on. And as I talked about yesterday, I really feel like this is devaluing women in men's eyes. And I feel like it's a really, it's hindering them from having the types of relationships they want. I think it's preventing women as a whole from really getting deeper relationships. And, you know, if you really want to have a real relationship with a man, there's one simple thing that you need to do. You need to be different than all the other women that are out there. So for most men, here, let me explain something about men that I think is very kind of significant and important in terms of this whole hookup culture thing and why it's so important to be different. For most men, it's far easier to go from being in a committed relationship to being in a casual relationship than it is to go from being in a casual relationship to being in a committed relationship. And, you know, one of the things that happens in a man's mind when you just start, you know, when you just hook up with a guy is that he might have been open to something serious and real with you before the hookup, and just hooking up with him might have cut that off for him. So studies have shown that going from a casual relationship to a committed one works like 1 out of 9 times, which if you don't know, is not a lot. It does mean that it can work sometimes, and I'll talk more about that in other videos. But for the most part, it's really difficult for a man to go there. But for women, generally speaking, what I found is that a lot of women jump into kind of hookup relationships, casual relationships, because in their mind, they're thinking, oh, I'm just going to go, you know, have fun with this guy. And they don't realize how things really work for them when they get into that sexual relationship. So first, what I want to do is tell you some rules that I think that you should follow in order, if you want to have the committed relationship that you want with a man in the age of the hookup culture. And so the first rule is kind of what I was just talking about, which is knowing how things work for you. So usually when I talk to a woman who is in a casual relationship, who's trying to get into a committed relationship, what she'll tell me is that she did it because she thought it would be fun at the time, right? And then she ended up catching feelings, as I like to call it. And next thing you know, that she was having sex with this guy and she started falling in love with him, and now she wants a committed relationship with him. You know, like I just said, that's not how things work for men. Right? Men typically, unless he goes into it thinking, you know, I do want something more with this woman, there's a really high probability chance that he's not going to want anything more with you if you just hook up with him. And so, you know, I know guys who have been in relationships or casual friend with benefits relationships for 10 plus years with women, and they don't want anything more with that woman other than just to hook up with her. And usually by that time, the woman is like, hey, I think we're in this committed relationship. And then there's this big fight that ends up happening. And usually there's a really painful breakup that comes from it because the woman starts to realize that she just wasted 10 years of her life with this guy who wasn't serious about her ever. And so, you know how things work for you. As a woman, how things tend to work is that if you start sleeping with a guy, you'll eventually develop feelings for him. And that's not how it typically works for men. So just keep that in mind. If that's you, just know that that might happen to you. So rule number two is have some standards. Friend with benefits is not a stage from meeting a man to marriage. And so if you want to have something serious and exclusive with a man, don't waste your time getting into situations that have very little chance of giving you what you want. Instead, figure out what it is that you want and you need from a relationship and make sure that you're getting those things before you jump in, right? So make sure that he's not involved or emotionally connected to another woman. Make sure that he's ready to get into something serious. Make sure that the two of you can support each other and what you value and want in life. And have real conversations with a guy about these things. So a guy's not going to force you to have a conversation with him about these. And trying to kind of figure out what's going on with a man, like he's some kind of jigsaw puzzle that you're trying to put together without looking at the finished picture, doesn't work. You need to make sure that you have real conversations with them. And a man that's just trying to have something casual is going to avoid these conversations. So and if he's looking for something real, he'll be honest with you about it. So make sure you're having those conversations and make sure that you're getting into something that you want to get into from the start. So rule number three goes along with rule number two, and it's setting and maintaining boundaries. So women who end up in the types of relationships that they want with men are the types of women who move on from situations that they don't want until they find what they do want. You might want to write that one down. So if you're the women that end up in relationships that they don't want are women who just stay in bad relationships, or they ignore red flags, or they just hang out with guys that aren't exactly what they want for a long period of time. They end up settling. They end up really being resentful. They end up breaking up 10, 15 years later, coming back and going, man, I wish I didn't just waste so much of my life with this guy that I didn't really want, and just talk to women in our community about that. You'll hear tons of women tell you these horror stories of wasting time with men, and it's really a painful thing. So women that get into the relationships they want, they don't accept men into their lives who aren't mature enough and aren't ready to create the type of relationship that they want to have. They don't have sex with these types of men. They don't try to trick these men into wanting something more with them. And they don't get into situations that don't serve them and then try to hope and pray that it turns into something that they want. Believe it or not, if you hold a standard for men and you stick to it, a man is much more likely to step up to the plate and give you a real relationship than if you don't hold those standards, then he'll just assume that you're willing to let him walk all over you, treat you like a sex object, and never require anything more from him. And if you don't have that standard set when you meet a man, if you don't have these boundaries that you stick to, even if a man was open to having something more with you before, it's like it flips a switch in a man's mind where he no longer sees you as relationship and marriage material, and it makes him start thinking of you as something that's more casual. And I know that sounds bad, but it's really about value here. If you believe that you're a valuable woman and you project that value to a man, if he believes that you're valuable as well, then he'll move mountains for you. He'll travel across the world for you. And if he doesn't see that value in you, then he won't. He won't do any of that for you. And so part of it is maintaining boundaries and believing that you are valuable in yourself. And another part of it is him looking at you and feeling like you're valuable. And so it's kind of there's two kind of separate components there, and you need both of them there. And the boundaries part is believing in yourself and believing that you're the valuable one. So rule number four is discovering what really works in getting the relationship that you want. So here are some things that do not work in getting the relationship you want. Convincing a man that you're perfect for each other, that never works. Using sex to try to make him feel something for you, that doesn't work either. Buying a man gifts or doing favors and errands for him, that's really being in your masculine. And that's, when you're masculine, when you're in your masculine, a guy might like you, but at best he'll think of you as like one of the guys, or think of you as something casual. Another thing that doesn't work is playing games or using manipulation tactics. That stuff works short term, doesn't work long term. Seeking his approval, that just makes your value go way down and makes him see you as somebody that he doesn't want anything to do with. Calling or texting him all the time. I talk more about this in some of my videos and programs and stuff, but there's a thing called mirroring, and that's really where you want to be when it comes to calling and texting. I don't think you should play games around this, but at the same time, I don't think that you should, kind of be obsessive about it either. So shaming or bullying him into being the man that you're looking for, this is like the worst possible thing that you could ever do to a man. And so many women do this, and it never ever works. It's never ever worked. And I think it's kind of this righteous, like, yeah, I deserve this and you need to act this way type of thing. It doesn't work. That doesn't work with men at all. It'll never work. Don't do it. It'll just destroy your relationship. It'll make him hate you. Avoid that at all costs. And the last thing is listing your impressive resume or talking about guy things or becoming the social planner of his life. And we talked about being masculine. This is more masculine type stuff. If you're being masculine around a man, it's just not attractive. Even if he was attracted to you before, it's a total turnoff for guys. You know, it makes them go, ugh, a big thing that I talk about in a lot of my programs and videos and stuff is this thing about investment, and a guy has to invest in you. And we'll talk more about that later. So all the things I just mentioned are all things that will immediately or eventually make a guy lose interest in you, pull away, and disappear altogether. And so what a man really needs in order to want this long-term committed relationship with a woman is he needs to feel like she is the one that he's been looking for his entire life, or at least she might be this amazing woman that he's looking for. And, I just want to make a clarification here. I didn't say that a man needs to think. I said that he needs to feel, right? So I think a lot of people underestimate the amount of stuff that men do based on how they feel. And a man, especially around relationships, he's looking for that feeling. He wants to feel like this woman is the one. You know, a man's not going to chase you. He's not going to pursue you. He's not going to commit to you unless he feels this thing that makes him say, this is a special, amazing girl that has come into my life. And so if you want to know more about what makes that a man feel that kind of feeling for you, I've got a link to a video underneath this video. You can go to that and check out more about what makes a man really feel like you're the type of woman that he's always been looking for in his life.